is my breakfast pretty much every day, for right now at least. Chicken sausage, bell pepper, spinach, and a little bit of strawberries.
Good morning, Bruno. Good morning. Hey, can you go potty? Do you gotta go potty? Let's go, come on. Let's go potty.
Look at these floors.
We went swimming last night and our concrete is not sealed. So we bring all that fun powder stuff into here. And what I'll be doing first today.
You gotta go potty?
Yeah.
Good morning. Hey, bud. Bexley. Hey, bud. Good morning. Time to get up and get some breakfast.
So the boys, something's going on with their air conditioning, and it's like in the 90s now in Louisiana. So anyways, their air conditioning is like, it's really hot in the room. So I don't know if you noticed, they were asleep on the couch. So we've been letting them sleep in the game room the past few nights because we're trying to figure out what's going on with their air conditioning units. So that's why they were asleep on the couch. But so I just got them up. I gotta mop some floors because we swam last night and our cement isn't sealed yet. So our feet marks make Or our feet make marks on the floor every time we come back in, which is really annoying. So we need to get those sealed pretty quickly. So just about every morning that we have school, I'll just get up, get dressed, do a few chores. I like to eat breakfast and have my coffee before I get the boys up. Otherwise, I would not be a very happy person in the morning. So I like to have my breakfast and my coffee time and even just a little bit of relaxation in the morning, quiet time before I even get the boys up. So I usually try to get up around 6:30 and I'll start waking them up around 7:45-ish, give or take, depending on what we've got going on. Bo and I work out, my husband and I, we work out in the afternoons at 4. So little side note, I just get dressed. I mean, nothing fancy, obviously. I've got a t-shirt and blue jeans on. But I don't change into my workout clothes until later in the afternoon. And I really do that because, a mentor of ours, he is an author and, has written books for a little over 40 years. And he told me once that obviously he works from home. And he told me once that he learned to get dressed and get ready in the mornings, even though his office was at home, because it kind of helped him separate that business attitude with I'm just at home and relaxing attitude. Otherwise, it was really difficult for him to get work done. And so I've kind of taken that concept into our homeschool, so that we don't, you know, we don't school in our pajamas. And even like my workout clothes, I don't transition into that until later before I go to the gym. And I just find it helps me personally with my attitude of, okay, this is school time for today. Because if not, it's really easy for me to just kind of be chill and relax and not switch that school mode on for me. So anyways, that's what we do. So I'm just going to put a very little amount of makeup on because I'm not going anywhere. And so I'm not going to really get ready on a normal day unless I've got, errands to run, which I don't today. So
mm-hmm.
we did in this house was these baskets. So as I do the boys' laundry, they each have a basket and I put their clothes in there. And every day that's part of their chore is to bring their clean clothes up. Did you find something?
Yes, ma'am.
Hey, sleepyhead.
Hey.
Can you get up and get dressed and brush your teeth, please?
Something's in the toaster heating up.
Oh, okay. Oh, Brittany!
It already popped, thanks. It's the already.
Ugh. Bruno. Why do you like to get in the pond? Why? Go to the garage. Come on, Bruno. I'm going to mop the floors right here while y'all finish getting dressed. Bruno! Hey! Hey! We got to go inside, okay? Guys, look at these banana trees. They were so tall, and I mean tall meaning like maybe 2 to 3 feet tall, and our goat came and ate them. So they are growing back again because we finally built a fence in the back few acres of our property. All right, let's go to your room. Good boy. Good boy.
He's a good boy.
Knowing about.
Alright, so you know how earlier I was looking at dog breeds, right?
Uh-huh.
So there was this one. You labeled it as very expensive. But in the description, it said they sold one in China for $1.9 million.
Stop. What kind of dog was that?
I don't remember.
That's kind of important. So Brooks is looking into starting a dog breeding company to earn some money. So we told him he needed to research and find the top 3 breeds of dogs that he is interested in. So that's what he's doing right now. But seriously, $1 million for a dog? I don't think so. A what? Oh, a Tibetan Mastiff. For how much?
$1.1 million.
I'm getting information right now. $1.9 million. Wait, but is that US dollars? Is that U.S. dollars? Because that could be a big difference. I don't know what the currency is in China. Okay, so we'll get back to you on that one. But I did finish the floors. Didn't take me too long because I'm not doing all of the floors. I did that a couple of days ago. And I already had the mop water left over from that. Might not need to admit to that, but... That's what I used, and that's how I roll. So we're about to start school and get going with our day. What do you call that?
It's not mine.
Oh, where'd you get it at? I'm gonna call it driving the bus.
All right.
Okay, so by the time the boys have eaten breakfast and they're getting ready for school, I'm usually ready for my second meal or at least a snack. So this is what I'm doing for today. It's just like a cup of Greek yogurt, and I sweeten it just a little bit with one packet of stevia. Mix that together, and then I just add, I prefer, their Whole Foods makes a blueberry almond granola, and I ran out, and I had this left over from a shower. Don't judge me. I put just a little bit, maybe a fourth of a cup of granola, probably not even that much. Dark chocolate hemp seeds, also purchased from Whole Foods, and blackberries. I prefer blueberries, but this is all we had, and clearly I need to go back to the grocery store. So, we're going to do our memory cards. What do we always start out with?
Presidents.
Presidents.
I thought it was requirements for becoming a...
No!
Let's do presidents first.
Yes.
Okay. I'm going to do the beat. Let's try to go a little bit faster than normal. What do you think?
What if I do the beat then?
I'll do it. That way...
If we'll start slow and then we'll go fast.
Here we go.
George Washington, John Adams, Thomas Jefferson, James Madison, James Monroe, John Quincy Adams, Andrew Jackson, Martin Van Buren, William Harrison, John Tyler, James Polk, Zachary Taylor, Millard Fillmore, Franklin Pierce, James Buchanan, Abraham Lincoln.
Tell me about the Senate.
There are 100 senators, and there are 2 in each state.
And how many year terms do they serve?
2.
Nope.
4.
6. Brooks, tell me about the House of Representatives.
There are 435.
Mm-hmm.
They're depending on the state's population, mm-hmm. people, the amount of them. And there's 2 year terms.
Very good. So Bexley. What are the 3 branches of government?
The legislative, the judicial, and the executive.
Very good.
One day, when Alfred was quite a little boy, he was playing with his big brothers while his mother, Aspergu, sat watching her children and reading. The book she read contained the lyrics of old English songs.
Blue and red. As Asperger turned the pages, Alfred saw the pretty pictures. So he left his play and came to lean against his mother's knee to look at them. What a pretty
book. Okay, so we said King Alfred the Great was selfless. What's another reason that we call King Alfred the Great?
He was humble.
He was humble. Good. Add that to the blackboard.
This looks like a completely new word. Hawaz.
Hawaz.
Yeah, we need a little bit more space there.
One of our activities is to make an illuminated letter. So the boys are working on this. This is Bexley's B, which is, I guess, a modern version of an illuminated letter. And I'm pretty sure that's like Fortnite characters. And this is Brooks's M.
Okay, lunchtime. We had company over yesterday and had burgers and dogs. So I'm doing leftovers for lunch. And got protein. Cheese is my fat. Bun is my carb, and I always try to eat vegetables with every meal. I'm working out today, and I know we're gonna have an intense cardio with it today, because I know what the workout, the WOD is. So I'm doing both of my buns because I need the carbohydrates for later. If this wasn't a workout day, then I probably would not do the bun, or maybe even just half the bun, or do like a sweet potato, like a small sweet potato. Instead, but anyway, so protein, fat, carbohydrates, and vegetables are something I try to do at every meal. All right, Bex, will you unload the dishwasher, please?
Let's see how fast you can do it. You have 5 minutes.
What did you want to do? Oh, snap.
You have 5 minutes, Bex.
Okay, let's not rush because then something might break. This is a new chore chart that we're trying that we use for a week, and I really, really like it. Brooks, tell us a little bit about how it works.
All right, so we do one chore. We get a point. We mark it off, and then we get a point. All right, so we can do 7 chores a day, every day, every single day. We can have a max of, I don't know how many points, but anyway, once we get to 25 points, we get electronics time,
for the weekends. But after we get our 25 points, we can keep doing our chores.
Each point is worth
a dollar.
A dollar. So if they make 25 points, they get electronics time on the weekend because they aren't allowed to have electronics Monday through Friday. And if they go beyond 25 points, then each point is worth $1. So that's a way for them to earn money during the week. Yeah. Okay, Bexley, write this sentence. I found a piece of cardboard in the wilderness. I found a piece of cardboard in the wilderness. Do you want to wear the stiff cloak or the raincoat?
Don't worry.
Okay, underline the compound word.
Yeah.
Very good. Okay, yeah. Look at, all of your words are spelled correctly, but I want you to look at where. You spelled it correctly, but is that the right use of that word where?
Should I erase it?
Well, tell me first, is it correct? Somebody. What does W-H-E-R-E mean? When would you use that in a sentence?
Where is like a place.
That's right. Now we're talking about wearing a piece of clothing. So what is the correct spelling of where for that? Do you know? What is it? You want to write it down?
I will write it down.
Okay. That's right. W-E-A-R.
Elizabeth Kenny in Australian Bush Blend Part 5. The education of the Kenny children was based upon a threefold principle, a love for the Bible, for poetry, and for people. The children looked forward to the twilight hour when their mother would read to them before
while
they went to bed.
His other arm hugged him with a large bunch of violets and golden blossoms. Indeed, he looked so bright and full of
life. Did you move the other ones into your master envelope?
Yep.
Okay.
Or just, what is an independent clause? Give an example. an independent clause is a clause that could be alone as a sentence.
We used real big numbers. So three rules is the main thing. And there are seven symbols, unlike decimal system, which goes 0 to 9. So let's try it. Here's the first one. I, which is usually written as a capital I, represents 1. And you can use that up to 3 times.
How sure your turn to play?
Pretty good. I need to subtract 700 from 3,599.
All right. Did you set it up?
Nope.
Set it up on your paper. Make sure to line up your ones, tens, hundreds, all your columns right.
Hey, Mom.
Yeah.
So this is multiplication, then this is... No, this is divide, and this is multiply.
Now I'm done with school, and now I'm done with school, and now I'm done with school.
All right, so we need to get ready for the gym.
Oh!
So, you're already changed, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So anything you need, go ahead and do that now because we leave in about 10 to 15 minutes.
Yeah.
All right. I always prep a protein shake for me to take directly after my workout. Right now I'm using this Protein 1 powder from 5 Star, the Caramel Cookie Crunch. I just mix it with water and it's fantastic. And I put a little bit of ice so that by the time I drink it, it's still cold. And then for pre-workout, I'm using this Beyond Raw Lit. I don't take any supplements, and this is really the only thing that I'll take occasionally, like maybe twice a week, depending on if I have a really heavy lift day, or I just need an extra boost, like today, because I have an intense WOD. So I went ahead and mixed that, and I'll start drinking it like maybe 30 minutes before our workout.
Hi, Bryn. Be good. We'll see you in a bit.
Bexley, you know where your shoes are? You ready to go? Do you need your gym bag? I think it's hanging up in the lockers area. What are you looking for? You have 30 seconds. 29, 28, 27. Just finished our workout. I am drinking my shake and it was exhausting. Like, all of us were exhausted. And the boys did like scaled version of what we did, which was pull-ups, push-ups, air squats, and then we did rowing 4 rounds. Anyways, we're exhausted. So we are eating dinner at Panera Bread.
No more research. But I think you're, but I think you're on the right track.
Yeah,
John,
I am about to be
1.9.
That's a lot of money. Yeah, and it said it was one of the rarest stars in the world.
Right.
Just got home from Panera. Bo and the boys have to make a stop real quick. So I went ahead and left so I could come check on our baby chicks who are about 4 weeks old. And I need to make sure that they have their food and water. And also check our pigs. I'll show you our pigs in just a minute. So the silver ones, or the gray ones, I hatched those myself in our incubator for the first time. They are lavender Orpingtons. We have, I believe, 6. And then we have some barred rocks, some Morans, and a couple of Americanas. So I have 12 total right now. So, hey, bud. Hi. Hey, buddy. How are ya? You are muddy. You are muddy. Oh, you want your belly rubbed. Oh. Yes, Big Daddy loves his belly rubbed. My goodness. It's so hot. I need a good belly rub every now and then. Huh, Big Daddy? Huh. Hey, bud. Hey. You got mud everywhere. That's how I know they're hot. The hotter it gets, the more mud they have because they just want to make themselves comfortable in a big mud puddle. That's my guy right there. There's the babies. Hey, Mama. There's Mama and her babies, some of them. She's got 8 babies. Hey, sweet thing. Look at that one with its ear. Its ear stuck like that. Well, come on, little thing. Hey, Mama. So we're at the end of the day. We got our school done. We got our workout done. Dinner, checked on all the animals. So now just waiting on the boys to still get back. We'll all get showers. Actually, we might get in the hot tub for a little bit because I think all of us were pretty exhausted from that workout. So they'll get home. We might do a little bit of pool time, definitely some hot tub time for the muscles, and chill and go to bed early is the plan. Going to video me tucking the boys in, and they are passed out. We are exhausted, so that is it for today, and I will see you guys soon.